Hey, Nick here from GuitarDojo.ca, and after watching this free introduction lesson, you're going to be playing amazing guitar solos all over the fretboard, just like the pros, in any key in the next 15 minutes, even if you know zero music theory. Now, even though theory will be needed down the road, right now for this lesson, we're just not going to use it, like at all, because I'm going to show you a revolutionary system I've developed called the Fretboard Infinity Loop System. This free lesson will give you all the building block concepts that you're going to need to blow your playing up and really take it to the next level. I'm giving this away for free. I must be nuts. I just want you to have fun and realize just how easy playing the guitar can truly be. There are many more lessons in this series to really expand the entire system out and really spell everything out for you, including tabs, PDFs, backing tracks. But I mean it when I say the basics and everything you need is right here in this first lesson. I'm going to prove it to you right now, and you can be sure you'll be able to play lead guitar in any key without learning any crazy music theory or guitar skills. I'm so excited about this, as I've never seen any other teachers teach this system. I've seen a few parts here and there and a few of these concepts, but I've never really seen anybody put the entire thing together truly to give you the power to shred infinitely. So pay close attention, because I'm giving you the ultimate power-up, the keys to my kingdom, right now. This is the ultimate light bulb moment for guitarists, and your ultimate key to take your playing from wherever you are right now to places you didn't even think were possible. So just for now, toss theory out the window, forget everything you think you know, grab your guitar, make sure it's in standard tuning, there are even tabs below if you need them for reference, and now I'm going to guide you through the ultimate in improvisation ease with the Fretboard Infinity Loop System. It's time to rock. Okay, so reference tabs are below this video in the app, so have a look at that if you need to as we go through, and let's stop talking and get started. Remember, the whole point of this lesson is to avoid theory and thinking like a typical average guitarist. I want you to start thinking more like a musician, and to do that, at least for now, I'm going to teach you some basic concepts about how the guitar works. This is foundational to the entire Fretboard Infinity Loop system. The first thing we need to learn is that guitar is made up of three distinct but related regions. We can think of these like universes. I'm a big Star Trek nerd, so I hope this makes sense to you. We have Region 1, Region 2, and Region 3. Region 1 is made up of strings 5 and 6, Region 2 is made up of strings 3 and 4, and Region 3 is made up of strings 2 and 1. For today's lesson, we're just going to learn a couple of select notes from each two-string region. So in Region 1, we're going to use frets 3 and 5 on both the low E and low A, and that looks like this. That's it, just those four notes, nothing more for now. Now in the middle region, we're going to play the exact same four notes. However, since we are warping to a new region of space, we will have a spatial shift, and those four notes we learned previously won't be in the same spot on the neck. Instead, they will be here on frets 5 and 7 of the D and G string, and that looks like this. Can you see how they are the exact same four notes, only now we're a little higher? And then in region 3, we're going to play the exact same four notes again, only this time the warp threshold we have to cross is a bit more powerful, and instead of the same warp jump we made last time, we have to shift one more fret forward up the neck to travel the same distance to hit the same notes. So we'll be playing the 8th and 10th fret on strings 2 and 1. That will look like this. See, it's the same thing again, but now we're higher even than before. The most amazing part is this, and I'll dive into it a bit more in a bit, but every time we play notes in this way, in our two-string regions, these warp jumps will always keep the exact same relationship. So, now let's play all those notes together from low to high. It sounds like this. Cool, so now we have three regions and we have our selected notes in each region. Now, let's put these notes to use and learn some guitar licks so we can start soloing. Please keep in mind that these are just for demonstration, and you can and should create your own licks using these notes. And don't ever worry about running out, since with just these four notes in these three positions, there are over 479 million permutations of note combinations. We'll focus on just this first region for now. Here's lick number one. Here's lick number two. Here's lick number three. And finally, lick number four. Great, now we can start soloing using just these four licks in any order we like. Just in region one for now, here's what that might sound like. And this is using the backing track from the backing track section of the app, and it's included for free for you as well, so you can practice this technique. But you can honestly use any backing track that you like. See, that was pretty cool. And I was just using region one, and I was simply using our four licks that we just learned, trying to play them in time and rhythm with the backing track, but not really giving much more thought to it than that. Now think of all the awesome options we have if we multiply and use those same licks across the other regions and we mix and match, just like we did. So let's look at those same licks again, now in region two and three. Pretty great, huh? So now we have four licks times three regions, which is a total of 12 licks. Although they are the same, they actually sound different because they are in different regions of the guitar neck. Let's put on that backing track again, and now mix and match all these licks. You can see by using nothing else but those four licks in those three regions, we've got some really solid soloing going on. No changing or doing anything more fancy than just the basics for now, but just mixing and matching gives us a whole palette to work with. Don't forget, we did this with zero music theory or scales whatsoever. Again, there will come a time and a place for that, but for now, this is the key that will unlock the kingdom for you. This is very common practice amongst pro guitarists, narrowing down the number of notes they play to keep things simple and to really try to make the notes that they choose be musical and fit the tune. This will help creativity grow and bust you out of a rut of simply running up and down scales or practice licks mechanically over and over again, which sounds super boring. Think about it. Like I said in my video that you clicked to get here, you probably are stuck in the same pentatonic scale or mode that you learned however long ago. And you might even be able to zing through it really quickly. But at the end of the day, it's never truly musical. It always just sounds like a technical practice exercise. So now, you're a step ahead of all those other guitarists that know some scales, but really can't seem to get out of them. I'm sure by now you're probably wondering, or at least have some questions about how to play all over the neck, like I promised. And that's going to be the next part of this lesson, and in truth, the further lessons in this series. But you now have the fundamental building blocks of the Fretboard Infinity Loop system. So these notes across the three regions that we've learned so far, remember these guys? These are all set up in the key of A. Now it kind of fits A minor best, but truly could be A major as well. So for now, let's just say A. Remember, I told you I didn't want to bore you with theory. The important thing to remember, A is the root that we are working with. You can find the root note A in each of these regions in each set of four notes. And in fact, it looks the same. It lives in the same space in each region. And that is the second note of the four note square. So in region one, it's fret five. It looks like this. To really start to understand the fretboard infinity loop system, you're going to need to learn just the names of the notes on the low E string for now. All 12 notes of the musical alphabet live on this low E string. If you don't already know, the musical alphabet is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and then it repeats, starting again on A. So it goes like this. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and on and on and on. See? Like an infinite loop. See what I did there? Anyway, it's also important to know that there are sharps and flats in between each of these notes. However, I said I wasn't going to bore you with lots of music theory in this lesson, and I'm not. So let's just work on memorizing the positions of the most commonly used keys for rock. Those are A, which we already know, G, E, B, and D. You can fill in your knowledge of where the rest of those notes are on the low E string at any time, but for now, the note locations are here.
A, G, E, B, and D.
You can even play the exact same links we just learned in any of these new keys. In fact, you can play them in every key. The system just moves in a loop. So what does that look like in G, for example? Or how about E? And now you can use those licks and come up with more of your own and start soloing around the fretboard like a pro in any key. Seriously, find some backing tracks on YouTube or even here in my app and play around. There are some in the app and even more that are downloadable in the Dropbox that you get access to should you decide to become a member of Guitar Dojo. So all you have to do is, whatever key you are adapting your square shape to, make sure your third finger lines up with the root on the E string. Then just go to town across all those different regions that I showed you. I hope your mind is blown. Mine sure was when I first learned this. Whew, that was a lot of fun, eh? I hope you enjoyed that lesson as much as I enjoyed sharing it with you. Of course, I left all the theory out of this lesson, but we still covered a lot. And like I said, I've given you the basic building blocks for the entire fretboard infinity loop system. If you feel like your head might explode, that's cool, no worries. I wanted to give you enough to work with so that you could walk away from this free lesson and actually go and solo in any key anytime and actually have fun with getting a sense of what the fretboard infinity loop could actually do for you. If that means your brain is now overflowing with new info, then I did my job right. If you feel a bit overwhelmed, that's great. My best advice though is to now take a break, have a Kit Kat, go have a coffee or a beer, and then come back and watch this lesson again, because I guarantee 100% that the second time you watch this, you'll get even more out of it than the first time around. So you'll catch all the little tips and tactics that you probably missed the first time. Now for a quick lesson recap. We covered the steps to play awesome lead guitar solos without using any music theory, I might add, using the fretboard infinity loop system, and we learned how to use it to jam over backing tracks in any key.
Congratulations on making it all the way through the lessons. A couple things to clarify. You probably heard me mention in the lesson about the app. I think the coolest part about the fretboard infinity loop system is the fact that it's actually delivered to you via a smartphone app, which of course is a huge time saver, so you don't have to drive back and forth to the music store all the time. You're not only saving time, but you're saving money on gas, wear and tear on your car, and of course just that convenience thing. So like, if you want to take a lesson at 3 a.m, you can open up the app and away you go. You can also access all of the lessons and materials via regular web browser. Some of the other bonuses that come with the app: downloadable access to all the charts, tabs, diagrams, and more, backing tracks, as well as bonuses like ear training, lick library, complete reference library for all of the scales, modes, pentatonics, all of that kind of good stuff. And of course, it's go at your own pace. You can go back and review it as many times as you like. And of course, as I said, once you go through the entire 10-week course, you'll actually have access to review forever. Now, the next step is, if you like this lesson and you're excited to start working with me, click the link down below and that will take you to the sales page where you can see some testimonials from some of my other students and you can read all of the bonuses that you get with the program. And of course, the big question mark, how much is it? We'll see you on the other side. I'm super excited to start working with you.